Hey there, today we're going to be recapping The Admiral. This film follows a legendary admiral fighting what seems like a war, where the winners and losers have already been determined. He refuses to back down and seeks to fight to the death for the king. Spoilers ahead. It's 1597. Legendary Joseon Admiral Yi Sun Sin is accused of being a Japanese double agent and is tortured as a result. The Japanese appear to be winning, so a desperate king pardons the admiral. With only 12 ships left, the admiral is tasked with the impossible, to win the war. Now, during a briefing, Captain Bae Seol questions the admiral, looking for answers to get his plans, and gets frustrated at the lack of information the admiral offers. Other captains stand up and defend the admiral, telling Bae to be respectful in the admiral's presence, and as you can imagine, he's not a fan of such a command. Eventually, Sun Sin ends the briefing, and Bae begrudgingly leaves. Yi Ho looks at his father, who slumps down in his chair. He's not doing well, and it's clear he's on borrowed time. Now, the Japanese marvel at their impressive fleet of nearly 300 ships, as Commander Todo Takatora walks with his first lieutenant. They discuss the status of the war and remain confident that they're on the cusp of victory. Takatora wants to forge ahead, but knows that the Chancellor is making him wait for a secret weapon to defeat Sun Sin. Now, out on the throes of war, a field of bodies are surrounded by Japanese soldiers, led by Wakisaka Yasuharu. The captain of this crew is still alive, and hears his son scream out for him. He attempts to kill Yasuharu, but is killed by an assassin who's hiding in the bushes. It's then that the infamous Kurushima, the King of Pirates, makes himself known to all. Immediately, Yasuharu and Kurushima aren't enjoying each other's company. So back at the outpost, Sun Sin's scout, Lim, tells the admiral of all he's seen. The enemy's fleet, their bloodlust, and how they steal from innocent people. He finally tells them that they're ready to deploy any day now. Sun Sin asks if the rumors of the reinforcements are true, and Lim nods, confirming what he already knew. If he doesn't act, the capital will run red with blood of the dynasty. He gives Lim a note to deliver to their spy, a Japanese defector by the name of Junsa. The old shipwright calls out as the scout runs off, announcing the figurehead is completed for their new turtle ship. Before we go on, like the video, smash the subscribe button, and turn on that notification bell to join our expendable squad. And as Lim leaves, his wife gives him a parting gift. So while in a briefing, Kurushima walks in with his lackeys and question why he's been kept waiting. His boys are ready to go, swords raised at all times. He ignores Yasuhara's joke and moves forward, looking at the map. He tells them that he's surveyed a region and then relays his plan to them. To ride in the morning, resupply at night, head to the capital, and finish the war victorious. It's argued that Sin's son isn't to be taken lightly, but Kurushima tells him he was sent by the Chancellor for a reason. Angered at the mention of his name, he launches at the Pirate King only to be stopped in his tracks. Kurushima tells him that the admiral will fall before making Takatora decide on which plan to go with. He won't admit it, but he's afraid. He sides with the Pirate King and invites him to sit and converse. Now, after praying, Sun Sin and Ho have dinner together. Ho makes it clear that he wants his father to walk away from this fight. He knows that his father is sick and might die in this war. And for what? A king who's not worth fighting for? Sun Sin feels his son's resentment for the king when he asks why he continues fighting for a king who'd leave them stranded if necessary. He tells him that it's about loyalty. Now, Ho's dismissive and presses him further, but Sun Sin tells him to eat, ending the discussion. As the morning comes, the admiral walks out to see people crowding the docks. He asks what all the commotion is about before seeing the severed head of a man he once served with hanging from the sails. Panic and fear manifest within the soldiers and peasants, and it's only made worse when they lift the covers to find a treasure trove of severed heads, all missing ears and noses. Yasuharu storms into Kurushima's quarters and demands answers to why he sent the severed heads. However, Kurushima is calm and proud of what he did. This attitude infuriates the Pirate King, and he wonders how they'd even fight back considering their state. He pokes at Yasuharu, asking if a defeat at Sun Sin's hands caused him to become weak, causing Yasuharu to attack the Pirate King. Now, the pirates defend their king and attack Yasuharu as well. Kurushima threatens him by telling him to watch himself, and that he'll kill him himself. And once that dust is settled, Kurashima has sake with the assassin, telling him that this fight with Sun Sin is personal, and tasks him to take him down. Now a soldier who's caught fleeing is brought to the admiral. He begs for his life, but Sun Sin executes him for his disloyalty. Everyone's shocked. The soldiers realize there's no escaping this war. But Cial disagrees. Sun Sin, Ho, and the shipwright travel to the cliff's edge, where they look out into the water and its roaring currents. They know the Japanese plan to use these waters to get to the capital, and Ho questions if the turtle ship can handle the treacherous waters, all the while Sun Sin remains silent, hearing the currents at work. So now over dinner, Ho concerningly asks if the turtle ship is the only tactic he has. Sun Sin argues that tactics matter less than the fact that there is a growing fear in the ranks, spreading like a plague. He wonders how his father plans to quell the fears. He's left more confused when he says that he'll attempt to use the fear to his advantage. So that night, the admiral dreams of his fallen friends who beg him to avenge their deaths. He follows him through the ship, but is soon met with an assassination attempt. Ho shouts to warn him, but a knife is already thrown, impaling Sun Sin. He fights back, with Ho helping. And while fending them off, the doors are open to reveal the turtle ship is on fire. He watches in horror as the ship burns, while Ho manages to defeat the last assassin, but not without an injury. Others arrive and see what's going on. They find out who's behind the attack, only to discover a member of Seol's men. They run after and kill Seol, all while the admiral watches his ship burn, visibly devastated. They hold him back as he collapses. Sakatora learns of Sun Sin's last turtle ship's destruction. Delighted at the news, he mentally prepares himself to call for war. Now Lim is out scouting over the Japanese fleet. He comes across someone on the run, and after hiding, he helps the escapee, but quickly realizes that he's severely outnumbered. After being chased too, he now joins the other prisoners. And as someone rides past on a horseback, he locks eyes with Junsa, the admiral's spy, who goes and helps the man being chased with the help of Subong, the slain captain's son. The admiral looks over the open waters and roaring currents. His eyes are transfixed on the whirlpool. His thoughts are interrupted by Ho, who brings a word from Junsa. He reads the letter from June and learns about Kurashima. With this knowledge, he tells Ho that they need to leave and move their men soon. Arguments are breaking out amongst the admiral's chain of command. They don't want to die in vain, but they see that's where they're heading. They approach and request to speak their truth, telling him this fight is futile. Without the turtle ship, they're doomed. They beg him to live to fight another day. And to their surprise, he agrees and gathers everyone. Now this is a family meeting they'll never forget. So they stand and wait, unsure of what's coming their way. More soldiers arrive, and the admiral asks if they brought what he asked for, to which they agree. He asks them to toss out the contents of their buckets and light it up. They set everything on fire, and the guards realize that they're in trouble. He berates them for only thinking of their own lives, not fighting until their last breath and choosing to avoid combat. He rallies his troops, telling them to fight till death in order to live. As he watches everything burn, he tells them he's burning it all to die at sea. The admiral meets Subong, and Sun Sin tells him that he fought alongside his father for over 6 years before giving him his father's garment, making him even more emotional than before. As Sun Sin's about to leave, Subong makes a request. He wants to fight for the admiral. He agrees. And that night, everyone ponders the war ahead, worried about their fate. So in the morning, the admiral walks on deck amongst fearful soldiers, who are not ready or particularly willing to die. He looks out and sees his son taking the civilians to the mainland before he calls out for full deployment. They're fighting whether they're ready or not. The boats leave, and Ho watches them depart. He remains resolved in his decision as the boats glide through the water, on their way to face an enemy with far greater numbers. Now as they approach the currents, he calls for the battle formation and all the boats begin to work harder to fight against the currents. Above deck, they ready their weapons. And then, in the distance, the Japanese fleet breaks through the morning mist and shows itself. The other ships stay back, fearing for their lives, leaving only the admiral's ship charging ahead before he commands them to drop anchor and remain idle. Kurashima calls for the first line of vanguard ships to descend upon him. Sun Sin commands his boat, ready to fire at the incoming boats. They draw their arrows and ready their cannons, while the approaching vanguard aims their guns to the sky and fires away. The bullets pierce the ship, but the Admiral doesn't flinch. They await the command to fire away, but instead he watches as the currents begin pulling the boats near one another before giving the order. They start firing away, hitting boats left, right, and center with the help of the currents. The enemy attempts to fire back, but most of their energy is left reeling from the effects of the currents and the onslaught of arrows and cannonballs being fired at them. Sun Sen's men fire explosive arrows, and it's becoming clear to the enemy where the Admiral's attention is, the front lines. Yasuharu wonders what he's waiting for. Why is he anchored in one spot? A soldier asks if they should press forward to help the front lines, but he says no. Ho watches from the mainland and remembers what his father said, that fear does not discriminate. And it's clear the enemy is filled with fear from their own defeats over the past 6 years of this war. But Kurashima's not afraid. He sends out more vanguard boats, telling them to be tougher than the last. The currents start working against the Admiral and his men, forcing them to cut loose and move closer to the isle. Eventually, they're trapped, and Kurashima uses this moment to his advantage. The vanguard approaches and begins an attempt to board the Admiral's boat. He awaits until they're crossing over to call for them to fire. They manage to fend off the first boat, but the second one seems more challenging. And now surrounded and seemingly overpowered, all hope seems lost. They attempt to kill the Admiral, firing directly at him. One of the Admiral's men causes an explosion on the boat, killing many and nearly taking out the Admiral too. He's struggling to get up, unable to hear. And now weakened, he watches as his soldiers lose the fight. He stumbles into the mess below, and a soldier helps him readjust his armor. He goes to his lieutenant and tells him to gather the cannons below deck and prepare them, while telling everyone else to hold their ground. Now below deck, they prepare the cannons while the Admiral defeats countless pirates. Sun Sen is told that they're ready, and he tells everyone to brace themselves as they let loose all the cannons and blast their way out of this mess. All the boats around him suffer. Ho and the enemy wonders what happened. Ho thinks back to what his father said when he asked how they could possibly instill courage in their men, and was told that in order for them to find courage, he needs to sacrifice himself. Yasuharu wonders if this is the end, but then the Admiral's boat emerges, blowing past the blockade. Everyone watching is shocked. The soldiers, now emboldened, kill the pirates with more vigor. The other ships in the Admiral's army come back and look to fight alongside the Admiral, who has proven that winning is possible, even under extreme circumstances. The old man watches from the aisle and sees the whirlpool beginning. The Admiral tells his soldiers to prepare themselves for Kurashima's attack and raise the flag. And as one of the soldiers does, the assassin fires and shoots him in the arm. Sun Sen looks for the origins of the shot, and it's after the second soldier's kill that he realizes where it's coming from. He grabs a cannon and aims it at the sniper's location and patiently waits before firing. He doesn't hit the assassin, but the flag is raised. The assassin goes higher and locks onto the Admiral while he's bandaging up one of his soldiers. As he's about to fire, he's shot in the eye with an arrow, causing him to narrowly miss. The assassin falls off the roof and into the water. With the fleet by his side, they push forward before realizing a vessel is approaching covered in straw. Sun Sen realizes what's about to happen and tells his archers to fire arrows immediately. Inside that vessel, the prisoners of war are rowing. Among them is Lim. The arrows are unsuccessful, and they're out of cannons. Finally, they find a torpedo-like device, which is their last hope. They prepare to fire it and send it off, colliding with the vessel and causing significant damage, but not enough. Lim warns them that the vessel has loads of gunpowder. He gets on top and attempts to steer it clear of the Admiral's ship. His wife was watching from the top of the mountain. She watches as a man stabs June twice before being shot with arrows. June tells his wife to make them fire at the vessel to avoid it colliding with the Admiral, but she tells him she can't. He begs her, and eventually she concedes. She screams and makes her presence known to get the attention of one of the ships in the Admiral's fleet. The others on the aisle join in, and eventually the ship notices. The captain tells them to prepare to fire at the straw-covered vessel. They fire and miss several times. Soon as they manage to hit it, although it causes intense damage to the ship, it's still seaworthy. The Admiral watches as Kurashima approaches. The men below deck try to prepare, but are faced with little options, considering the side of the boat is gone. As the lead vanguard ship gets to the Admiral's ship, the whirlpool takes them all in and takes the ships on a ride. Now joined at the hip, They fight in a close combat situation. The Admiral inspired his men and they fight their hearts out against Vanguard soldiers. Kurashima attacks the Admiral but is stopped by the currents, which causes him to fall back. He's told they need reinforcements, but he tells them that nobody's coming. He jumps on board the Admiral's ship and takes arrows to the chest, but barely seems to feel a thing. This dude is stabbed and shot at with more arrows than you could believe, and he's still not dead. Even with blood pooling out of his mouth, he goes after Sun Sin, who cuts off his head. Now the currents are getting stronger and the whirlpool more treacherous. The Navy's continuing its advance against them. The Admiral's told that the ship is failing him. And when all hope is lost, a group of boats come and attempt to pull the Admiral's boat out of the whirlpool. Meanwhile, the fleet is approaching expeditiously, causing the enemy to panic and demand that they speed up, despite the dangers presented. And the peasants manage to free the Admiral's ship out of the whirlpool. The Admiral commands the fleet to impact the Navy fleet, and they do, causing complete and utter devastation. They destroy the ships like they're nothing. The Navy begins to flee before Takatora calls for a retreat. The Admiral and his men celebrate this victory. Now, sometime later, Sun Sin and Ho walk through the fields. Ho wonders how his father knew to use the whirlpool when it appeared like an act of God in their most desperate moment. Ho suggests that the whirlpools were an act of God that helped them. But Sun Sin suggests that if it wasn't for the peasants' warning about the boat, they'd be dead. Finally, they arrive at the port, where they're constructing new ships. They take a new turtle ship to the water, never ceasing the fight until it's completely over. The Admiral was released in 2014 by Big Stone Pictures. It stars Choi Min-sik, Ryu Seung-rong, and Cho Jun-woong. Given the circumstances, would you fight alongside the Admiral if you'd been asked to? Tell us with the hashtag Cinema Recap in the comments.